one thing that a lot of people don't really even pay attention to is Twitter. And Twitter can actually make you money. You've got to follow the right people. You've got to follow the people that post on stocks that are moving. You've got to be able to follow the people that post good information. And you've got to be able to follow the people that will actually write pieces themselves and move the markets. Many overlook at just how powerful it's become. People don't want to look for information that's either on a press release or something that comes through the internet or emails or whatever. They want instant, 140 characters or less. Nobody has the attention span that they used to. Nobody wants to read paragraphs upon paragraphs. They just want exactly what's going on. They want the ticker. And that's really what Twitter has become. And it's a powerful tool because if you're quick, you've got a great edge. Personally, I use TweetDeck, tweetdeck.com. Twitter actually just bought them out and they changed it all up. It used to be a lot better if you have the old version of TweetDeck, but it's probably the best solution that you're going to have versus something like the website itself, going to twitter.com and trying to follow along there, because you can't get the same pop-ups that you do with TweetDeck, which will actually show you exactly what you're looking for. You have to follow the right people. You have to know why you're following certain people. You want to look for market movers, both on the long and the short side. You also want to look for other people that are posting where the moves are, the stocks that are moving, things like that. So you're going to develop who you want to follow over time. You can always take different recommendations and either follow them and unfollow them if they don't do what you're looking for. But I like to watch people that trade the same types of stocks that I do because it acts as a scanner. And I might miss something, but then all of a sudden I see it pop up and boom, I put it on radar and I see a trade right away, so I want to take it. So in many ways, it's just like you're using a scanner that you would use with something like Equity Feed or Dash Trader or any of those types of things that are actually going to produce ticker results for you. So good and timely information. I would recommend following at Mark Flow Chatter. Now he doesn't tweet as much as he used to. He kind of resides in our room and he puts the actionable trade alerts right in there. And he's faster than the street on the majority of alerts. He's very good at finding information before the rest of the street does. And by that, I mean by investigating and checking into and really dissecting 8Ks and all that kind of stuff. He's got a great team with him. And by the time that he finds it and posts it, there's other news cycles that are actually picking it up literally minutes, maybe 2, 3, 4 minutes behind him. And you've got probably a good 2 to 4 minute head start compared to all these other slower services. So it's a great follow and a great guy in the chat room. At TradeHawk is probably one of the best at scanning 8K filings that pretty much go unnoticed. And one of the best things that he used to do, although there hasn't been as many lately, is all the delisting alerts. And delisting meaning a stock's going from NASDAQ down to the OTCs. And he used to find it out quite often, way before the street. And you'd be able to get a great short off, and it'd actually be fact at maybe 11:30 a.m. or 12 noon, and the rest of the street finds out around 2 p.m. So everybody that finally has the confidence to short because they actually see the data ends up providing a nice downside to something that we might already be short. So it's a great person to follow, and again, he also finds a lot of other good quality information, which I'll show you here in a second. Then Offshore Hunter, this is Michelle, she's in the chat room. It's great for just free chart ideas. You can kind of get an idea of what she's looking at, what chart breaks to look for, and she blogs at tradeonthefly.com. And the good thing here is it just kind of keeps molding the types of charts that you should be interested in over and over and over again into your brain, and that's gonna make you a better trader. So here's an example with TradeHawk, and he was about probably 2 or 3 minutes before the street even picked it up, but they received an FDA orphan designation for some drug or whatever, and he posted it at 102. And you can see here, right at 102, and it went literally from about $1.55 up to 175, and then the rest of the street kind of picked it up, and it went all the way up to 250, consolidated, and up to 3. So it was literally a double from the time that he tweeted. So that's what he's really good at picking up on and finding way before everybody else. And sure, it looks like everybody else picked it up pretty quick here, but the fact is even 10, 20, 30 second head start or a couple minute head start is sometimes the biggest difference in the world. And the difference here is how much size are you willing to risk if it's coming off of a flat line versus chasing it up at $2. And if you're gonna trust a bigger size, it's gonna make all the world of a difference when it starts to spike another dollar.